In this video, I am going to explain three structures which can induce temporomandibular joint dysfunction. What is temporomandibular joint dysfunction? It is when you open mouth, the joint makes noise, like clicking noise. That's temporomandibular joint dysfunction, but it's very long name. So in this video, I will shorten the name. I will call it TMJ. Okay, TMJ means the dysfunction here. Okay, so in first part, I will explain ligaments by using pictures because these ligaments are not very well known. So if I use the bony model, you have no idea where these ligaments are. That's why I will use pictures in first part to explain where these are. In second part, I will use this bony model to explain where they are. Okay, so let's move on to the picture part. So let's check three structures. The first structure is this one. Actually, this is not ligament. This is the joint capsule of temporomandibular joint. Joint capsule is right here. If this capsule gets tight, it can create the TMJ. Okay? So that's simple, right? Joint capsule of this joint. Now I will look the jaw from inside on next picture. So this is the view from inside. This is inside of the mouth. You are looking the jaw from inside. That's weird, I know, but other two ligaments are located inside of the jaw. So these are the two ligaments. Let's look at one by one. This ligament is sphenomandibular ligament. Why? Because this ligament connects sphenoid bone and mandible. Sphenoid and mandible. That's why this ligament is sphenomandibular ligament. The next one is this one, this ligament. This ligament connects this bony process. This is styloid process. And mandible here. So this is stylomandibular ligament. Stylomandibular ligament. That's very interesting. Why? Because these two ligaments do not attach on this joint. The joint capsule attaches on this joint, of course, because this is joint capsule. However, other two ligaments, sphenomandibular ligament and stylomandibular ligaments, these two ligaments do not attach on this joint. However, these two ligaments are very important to treat TMJ. Of course, it's important to treat a joint capsule itself. However, other two structures are also important. I learned a ligament treatment technique and it works very, very well. Of course, there are other issues which make TMJ, like mastication muscles, or your head position is disorganized, or that can be from cervical area. There are so many reasons, but tight ligaments and joint capsule can also create TMJ. Okay, so let's go back to a real human bony model. So let's look each ligament and joint capsule on this model. The first one is this one. This is the joint capsule of temporomandibular joint. This joint is made from temporal bone and mandible. That's why this is called temporomandibular joint. So our opening and closing mouth happens here, this joint. So this is very, very important place for eating and speech. Okay, so this is the joint capsule of temporomandibular joint. This can be one cause for TMJ. Easy, right? So let's go to other two ligaments. What are they? What were these two ligaments? Let's check stylomandibular ligament. Remember, this is styloid process of
temporal bone. This is very sharp, bony prominence. So this is styloid process and connects to a mandible. Remember, this is inside of mandible. So let's make an imaginary line. This is styloid process and this is mandible. So imagine this ligament is like this, running like this way, inside, okay? Styromandibular ligament. What was the last one that connects the sphenoid and mandible, right? The ligament attaches on the spine of sphenoid and attaches on inside of the mandible, especially right here. It's very close to this hole, right here. That was sphenomandibular ligaments. Let's make an imaginary line as well, like this. Sphenomandibular ligament. The other one was styromandibular ligament. Sphenomandibular ligament. The interesting thing is that this hole right here inside of the jaw, the nerve, which is a trigeminal nerve, pass through here. So around this hole, the sphenomandibular joint attaches here. So if this ligament gets tight, it can create impingement for what? Trigeminal nerve. This part of trigeminal nerve supplies the sensation for lower teeth. So that can be a cause for tooth pain. Okay, but I'm talking about the TMJ dysfunction in this video. So let's review. The first one was this one, the joint capsule of the jaw joint. Okay, temporal mandibular joint. Simple, right? The second one was styromandibular ligament. Let's make imaginary line. The last one is sphenomandibular ligament. As I said, the TMJ dysfunction is very, very complicated. So there are many other reasons, like mastication muscles, the chewing muscles can be caused for TMJ. Maybe upper cervical area can be caused for TMJ dysfunction because the upper cervical, cranium, and jaw are related, or many other issues can be applied. But in this video, I explained the three ligaments which can be caused for TMJ dysfunction. I kind of used this ligament technique for TMJ and it looks like it works pretty good. So I hope this video helps your understanding of TMJ and ligaments around jaw joint. So if you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.